Robin's Roost, and we are so happy that it's a fun day today. Mostly, I'm super happy that it's sunny. I was able to sit outside and do my Bible study this morning, and it felt so good. Just love me some vitamin D, fresh air, sunshine, and fun glasses. I mean, it doesn't get much better than that. So, for 2020, I have three things for you today that I am thankful for, besides the ones I just said. First thing today, I am thankful for my parents. It's their anniversary. Happy anniversary, Mom and Dad. Mwah. They have only ever been married to each other. They've been faithful to each other all these years. They have been married since 1974. They're really old. But I love them, and I'm so thankful that God gave me parents who modeled what he teaches in his word, who taught me about the word, and brought me to church my whole life, and they're a part of my spiritual heritage. I love them. So thankful for them and the example of their faithful marriage. Number two, I am thankful for little kids. Oh my goodness, you guys. I started babysitting at like 13 years old, and there was this one family in particular that I babysat a lot. There were four kids, and they were so much fun. I love little kids. Little kids are the best. They are full of joy. It's super easy to get them excited about something. Everything is a new experience. I love it. I love little kids. Mamas, if you are stuck at home right now, feeling stuck with little kids, listen, I want you to turn that perspective. We've talked about it here before on The Roost. You can adjust your perspective like the letter N. When you turn it sideways, now it's a Z. With the Lord's help, his strength, and his grace, you can look at your perspective that feels like a burden, like being stuck home with little kids, and it turns into a joy if you look at it a little bit differently. Little kids make you laugh. They are funny. They say funny things. They're the best. I love little kids. I miss little kids. In fact, I told Mark for Christmas that I wanted either a baby or a puppy, and he didn't get me either one. It was like the worst Christmas ever. Little kids are the best. I love little kids. Third thing for today, I am thankful that by God's grace and through his strength, all things are possible. Now, that's not just a fun cliche or something really catchy that you've seen on a poster or a pillow. It's definitely not a good luck charm. Through God, all things are possible. It means that God will always accomplish what it is that he has to accomplish. He will always accomplish his will. He will always accomplish salvation. When Jesus said it in Matthew that with God all things were possible, he was talking about salvation. When Paul said it, he was talking about God accomplishing his will. God has the power and the ability to accomplish what he has purposed. With God, all things are possible. So getting out of coronavirus, it's totally possible. It's gonna happen. These trials are temporary, like we talked about yesterday. I have a little encouraging word from Johnny Erickson Tata today. It has to do, I'll just read it to you and you can hear. With God, all things are possible. And whenever I try to explain how I've arrived at this point, I shake my head in amazement. It has everything to do with God and his grace that sustains, not just over the long haul, but grace given in tiny moments, like stepping stones leading you from one tick of the clock to the next. And the beauty of God's grace is that it squeezes those hard moments together, eclipsing the years until one day you look over your shoulder and all you see is 5 decades of God at work. Try as you might, you can't recall the horror of it all. Grace softens the edges of past pain, choosing only the highlights of eternal importance. What you're left with is a peace that's profound, a joy that's unshakable, and faith that is ironclad. It's the hard but beautiful stuff of which God makes your life. Like, when did that happen? I cannot say, but I praise God for his amazing grace. See, with God, all things are possible, and he is refining each of us, even in this time of isolation and quarantine, to be more like his son if we are in Christ. Are you in Christ? I hope you are. If you're not, I'd love to talk to you more about it. I hope today finds you working on building that peace that's profound, the joy that's unshakable, and the faith that is ironclad. See you tomorrow, friends. In a strudel-doo, when we noodle, with a doodling song. What you call? A real ball. I do. Say you love me, really love me. Say you love me. Say you love me. Thank you, Miss Robin. Thank you, Miss Robin. Thank you, Miss Robin Brown.